name is Nick. The length is 3. Okay. So with the help of the pointer that you are supposed to perform. Okay. So I will come back to you guys at 10:34. हाँ जी, एनी वन डन? हाँ जी, प्लीज रिस्पॉन्ड क्विक. हाँ जी, एनी वन ऑफ यू प्लीज रिस्पॉन्ड. एम आई ऑडिबल? हाँ जी, प्लीज रिस्पॉन्ड. हाँ जी, प्लीज रिस्पॉन्ड. एम आई ऑडिबल? यस और नो?
यस सर.
ओके, प्लीज रिस्पॉन्ड. एनी वन ऑफ यू हैव डन? ओके, हरदीप कौर, प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ. हाँ जी हरदीप, हरदीप अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ. हाँ जी हरदीप, पवन कुमार. हाँ जी पवन, पवन अनम्यूट. चलो, रुचिका. रुचिका, ओके. सिमरनप्रीत कौर, हाँ जी सिमरन. हाँ जी करो एक्सप्लेन, वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग। हाँ जी रुचिका, वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग, वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग रुचिका, योर वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग।
सर
हाँ जी बोलिए।
सर हम ऐसा कर सकते हैं कि जो कंडीशन हम नॉर्मली देते थे वहां नॉर्मल एरे की लेंथ फाइंड आउट करने के लिए कि जो स्ट्रिंग की वैल्यू है i नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो जो स्ट्रिंग
स्लैश जीरो स्लैश जीरो स्लैश
स्लैश
जीरो नल
जी
करेक्टर।
हाँ तो वहां पे
ठीक है ऐसे ही करना,
स्ट्रिंग i की जगह हम वहां पे पॉइंटर डाल सकते हैं।
बिल्कुल ठीक है, और पॉइंटर को इंक्रीमेंट करते जाओ, बात खत्म।
यस सर
बिल्कुल ठीक है। हाँ जी
सर मेरा हो गया।
हाँ जी बोलिए क्या किया।
सर पहले मैंने स्ट्रिंग इनिशियलाइज की और एक वेरिएबल इनिशियलाइज किया आई। सर मैंने स्ट्रिंग को इनपुट करा लिया सर, फिर मैंने एक कैरेक्टर पॉइंटर लिया स्ट्रिंग स्ट्रिंग को इक्वलाइज करके। सर फिर मैंने लूप चलाई वाइल स्टार पी नॉट इक्वल टू नल कैरेक्टर, और फिर मैंने आई प्लस प्लस किया और बाद में पी प्लस प्लस किया।
हाँ बिल्कुल ठीक है।
यस सर हो गया सर आउटपुट आ गई।
बिल्कुल ठीक है। हाँ जी भावुक, भावुक आपने क्या किया, अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ।
तो ट्राई किया लेकिन
क्या ट्राई किया
सर, पहले इनिशियलाइज कराया पॉइंटर को।
पॉइंटर कौन सा आएगा इस बार,
क्या सर
पॉइंटर कौन सा आएगा, इंटीजर आएगा या करेक्टर आएगा।
सर करेक्टर,
क्योंकि पॉइंटर करेक्टर आएगा ना, हम करेक्टर पॉइंटर की बात कर रहे हैं इस टाइम। ठीक है तो ये चीज भी माइंड में रखनी है।
तो सर पहले सी आउट करवाया एंटर लेंथ ऑफ स्ट्रिंग, और फिर सर फॉर लूप लगाई जीरो से एन तक।
एन तक कैसे लगा दोगे आप, आपको कैसे पता लगा कि आपने, वही तो कैलकुलेट करना है दोस्त, आपको कैसे पता। आप यूजर से मांगोगे नंबर ऑफ करेक्टर दैट यू वांट टू एंटर, देन व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम। समझ रहे हो ना बात को।
यस सर,
क्वेश्चन तो यही है ना अपने को, वी हैव टू फाइंड इट आउट वेदर हाउ मेनी करेक्टर द यूजर एंटर। इफ द फाइव करेक्टर देन से ओके सिंपली जस्ट से फाइव करेक्टर्स, इफ 10 करेक्टर सिंपली जस्ट से 10 करेक्टर्स। But you are asking from user and you are running your loop into that context. That means the answer is the question is given by the user and the answer is again given by the user. Then what is the use of this code? Okay, this point into the mind. Okay. Anyone else? Okay, so I am asking again. Jaspreet Kaur, because Jaspreet was absent on personal interview as well. So still, she is absent. Yesterday or day before yesterday, I asked a question again to the Jaspreet and Jaspreet still muted. Today, two times, the Jaspreet still muted.
Sir, while loop...
हाँ जी हाँ जी, while से ही होगा, while से ही होगा. For से भी कर सकते हो, while से होगा.
Okay.
So better go with while. Okay, I am not sure. I just tried. Okay, Ruchika Raj. देखो रुचिका जी, नहीं अप्रोच कुछ हद तक तो ठीक है, लेकिन अपने को ये जो काम करना था, ये काम करना है पॉइंटर्स की बदौलत। तो ये जो कोड आपने दिया है, ये कोड आपने विदाउट पॉइंटर दिया है, और जो कोड विदाउट पॉइंटर है वो बिल्कुल ठीक चलेगा, लेकिन अपने को जो काम करना था वो काम हमें पॉइंटर की बदौलत करना था। ठीक है जी। तो कुछ कोड आपका ठीक है, ये अगर मैं पॉइंटर की बात नहीं करूं तो करेगा, लेकिन फंक्शन मैंने अभी कराया नहीं है। चलो एनीवेज आपने उसको फंक्शन में कन्वर्ट किया, गुड अप्रोच है, क्योंकि फंक्शन के बिना भी काम अधूरा है। चलो ठीक है, कोड ठीक है लेकिन पॉइंटर की बदौलत नहीं है। तो हम पॉइंटर टॉपिक डिस्कस कर रहे हैं, काम ठीक करेगा, आउटपुट ठीक आएगी, इसमें कोई दोरा नहीं है, लेकिन अपने को पॉइंटर के साथ मूव करना है। ओके, तो थिंक दिस इनटू द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द पॉइंटर्स। ओके, सो लास्ट वन, द लकी नंबर, द लकी नेम, द लकी नेम फॉर द लास्ट वन। ओके, किसका नंबर नहीं लगाया मैंने कभी, आई थिंक सिलिका, ये नाम मैंने कभी प्रनाउंस नहीं किया। हाँ जी सिलिका जी, प्लीज अनम्यूट। हाँ जी सिलिका, सिलिका जी अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ। सिलिका, ओके, तो अगेन कौन सा नाम है जो मैंने कभी प्रनाउंस नहीं किया, आई थिंक योगेश ढोलिया। हाँ जी योगेश,
am I audible sir?
हाँ परफेक्टली ऑडिबल,
यस सर।
हाँ जी बोलिए
सर। मैंने भी ऐसे किया था कि जैसे एक स्ट्रिंग करेक्टर स्ट्रिंग को इनिशियलाइज कर दिया, तो एक करेक्टर स्ट्रिंग ले ली जैसे सर, और उसके बाद एक हमने वेरिएबल ले लिया और एक हमने पॉइंटर ले लिया पी नाम से, और स्ट्रिंग को इनिशियलाइज करने के बाद उसकी जो वैल्यू वो पॉइंटर को असाइन कर दी, और उसके बाद हमने वाइल लूप लगाया, जब वाइल आई नॉट इक्वल टू, जब तक वो बैक स्लैश जीरो के बराबर नहीं हो जाता, उसके अंदर हमने आई की वैल्यू इंक्रीमेंट करते गए और जो पॉइंटर है उसकी वैल्यू इंक्रीमेंट करते गए, और बाद में आउटपुट में आई की वैल्यू को शो करवा ली।
परफेक्ट, परफेक्ट सर, पहले स्ट्रिंग प्रिंट करवानी देन पॉइंटर असाइन करना, करवाना वाइल लूप लगा के पॉइंटर वैल्यू इंक्रीमेंट करवा देनी, ठीक है जी, होगा तो यही, लेकिन अपने को तो टेक्निकल चाहिए ना। वो तो ठीक है, द कॉन्सेप्ट इज एग्जैक्टली फाइन, लेकिन अब हम इसको करेंगे कैसे, है ना, तो ये भी अब अपने को सोचना है। चलो एनीवेज, अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट, हाउ एग्जैक्टली द थिंग्स आर हैपन, very simple, very easy, the fundamentals behind this is same whatever we discuss into the last to last session, the referencing and dereferencing, that's it, fundamentals are always same, as I already told you, if you know the concept of these four lines, whatever we discuss into the first lecture of the pointer or might be the yesterday as well, so these four to five lines are the fundamentals of the pointer, if you have clarity about it, that's mean the pointers are nothing, pointers are nothing, okay, so you must have clarity about these four to five lines, whatever that we discuss into the first video, you can refer that video as well, okay, so understand this concept, let's suppose this one is the character array, okay, so character array, let's suppose char of a of 10, so this one is the character array, so this time I'm taking the array as a character and another pointer variable, and that pointer variable should be again the, you must have knowledge about this thing as well, if I am referring, understand this point, if I am referring character array or character address to pointer variable, that pointer variable should be character type. If I am referring the integer object, that character, that pointer variable should be the integer type. The if I correlate this term into the general terminology, if I am talking about girls, so it means this is Rina. Rina knows to Meena. Meena contain the address of Sheena. So it means this should be a girl. This should be a girl. This should be a girl. Okay. If I talk about the males, that mean Mohan, Rohan, Sohan. Okay, so everyone should be male. it you cannot do something like this, Mohan knows to Reena and Reena knows to Sohan. No, it is not possible in C++ in the context of this specifically. Okay, so same thing here, you have to take care about it. If you are storing the address of the character or float or anything else, the pointer variable should be having the same data type. Okay, should have the same data type. Keep this point into the mind. The character variable, it means I am storing the address of the character array. Character array means that pointer should be again to the character data type. Otherwise, you will get the error message. So that's why for make it generic, so what we understand into the last class, that is the void. Okay, void. Void means this one is a generic pointer. So on the runtime, on add, as soon as for the required, whatever data that you want to store that belong to the integer, that belong to the character, that belong to the float, you can assign, because this one is the generic pointer. Okay, otherwise you have to take care. Character address, that must be the character. Integer address, that must be this pointer, should be integer. Okay, so that's it for this particular discussion. So now moving back, this one is my array, and array contains NITIN, and the last value we know automatically it stores /0. The slash zero means the null. That means there is end of this array. In the context of C++, if the slash zero is there, that means that one is the end value. So I got a clue. I clue that I have to iterate this array until I don't get this value, because this means the end of this array. This means the end of this array. That means beyond this point, if I go to any way, this slash zero, that means beyond this point, there is none. Okay, so keep this point into the mind in the context of C, C++. But in the case of the Python and Java, I am not sure about Java. But in the case of Python, these things are not implemented. Keep this point into mind. Okay, so moving back, how I can proceed it? So first, as we know, we have to do the referencing. So this one is my pointer variable. Now I am referring. What I am referring? This P is equal to this array. That's it. Now I referred it. When I referencing it, that's me 202. Now P has take the address 202. That's me the first character address. So I need another variable who will count how many time my loop is executed. So I am taking I is equal to 0. So you can say the counter is equal to 0. That should be the int type. Int counter is equal to 0. Okay, so it will tell me how many times this loop is iterated, because I have to take care about how many times this loop is iterated, because that is the main problem statement. That means one by one I have to process this. So how many times I executed? One time, two time, three time, four time, and five time. Okay. So again, what I am doing? Again, what I am doing? Very simple. Now the main logic. While, how many step that I have to execute? While, asterisk sign of P, dereferencing, asterisk sign of P not equals to null. Okay, so asterisk sign of P mean, as we know, this concept is dereferencing. That's mean I am checking this n is not equals to zero. Condition true. Condition true, that what I have to do, C is equal to C plus one. Okay, C is equal to C plus 1. So now, again, now I have to jump on the another address. For jumping on the another address, what you are supposed to do, P plus plus. That's it. Okay, P plus plus. P plus plus mean that I am earlier in the very first stage, I am standing over here. Now I'm taking the jump of this. I took a jump of this, then I got the next address. Next address, for example, this is 1202. In the case of the character, I suppose it takes one byte. So 203. Something like this. Okay, something like this. Now in 203, that's again I got I mean that is not equals to zero, perfectly counter implemented. At the end of the entire scenario, now what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to print the length of string is C. That's it. Okay, see. That means the counter, how many time I this condition is successfully executed. So as we know, we have to check how many time that loop is executed, that condition is true. You are supposed to take the help of the counters. Okay, the counters are nothing. They are the variables, integer variable. That's it. Who incremented or who decremented. So this one is the funda. Very simple. Two line of code. That's it. Nothing too special. But we implement it with the help of the pointer concept. Because we are discussing the pointer concept this point of time. As I already told you n number of times, the pointers are very closely related to this array. So ice is again here. You are comfortable with normal scenario. You can proceed with the normal scenario. You are comfortable with pointer. You can proceed with pointer. But yes, pointer give you some benefits as well that we discuss in the in that video. What are the benefits of the pointers? Okay. So I think the picture is clear to everyone. If you have any doubt before proceed further, please let me know.
So the counter variable क्यों use करना पड़ा सर हमें?
काउंटर वेरियर हमें इसलिए यूज करना पड़ा क्योंकि हमें काउंट भी तो करना है ना. हाउ मेनी स्टेप आई एग्जीक्यूटेड. आपको कैसे पता लगेगा अगर मैं यहाँ पे काउंटर नहीं लगा रहा तो आपको कैसे पता लगेगा ये कितनी बार चला है. तो आप यहाँ पे आए, आप यहाँ पे खड़े थे, आपने एक स्टेप लिया तो एक हो गया, दो लिए दो हो गए, तीन लिए तीन हो गए, चार लिए चार लिए हो गए. ठीक है ना. विदाउट काउंटर हाउ यू कैन फाइंड इट आउट हाउ मेनी टाइम दिस लूप इज एग्जीक्यूटेड. इवन आई कैन नॉट टेल. है ना. P is equal to A. नहीं नहीं स्टार लगाने की जरूरत नहीं है. हाँ जी चलें आगे. हाँ जी चलें आगे.
Yes sir.
Okay good. So the next concept. Okay, there is very small concept. I think this concept is not available in older version of C++. I am not sure about it. Please check this concept is available or not. Even I am not sure about it. I implemented this concept into the C++ 11 version. So I am not sure it will work on your Turbo C or not. But yes, I am going to tell you one new concept. That concept is called reference. Or you can say the aliasing. Alias. You might have heard about this term alias. 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 Okay. So what is the meaning of the alias or referencing? Aliasing means you might definitely heard this term in the context of the MySQL as well. Aliasing means to giving the nickname. To providing the nickname. To providing the small name. That concept is called aliasing. Okay. So in the context of inner queries. In MySQL, you definitely heard this term, that concept is called aliasing. Like this, select a star from table name and you give the alias as P. Okay, now where P less than whatever the next query is there, you can implement something like this. So this concept is called aliasing. That means I'm giving this huge name and converting it to this R, is this P. Okay, whatever the name that you want to assign. So for example, just simple scenario, if I correlate this term into the real time scenario, let's suppose the person name is Raj Kumar Verma. Okay, something like this. So you can give the nickname to this person rather than to pronounce Raj Kumar Verma. It's a very huge name. You can pronounce something like this. RKB. Okay, RKB. So for example, Rudra Pratap Verma, very huge name. Again, calling this huge name, but I can give the aliasing for the same RPB. Okay, RPB. So this concept is called aliasing, that assigning a nickname. So rather than to pronounce a very huge name, Rudra Pratap Verma, I am just giving a simple name, that is the RPB. Okay, RPB, something like this. So even I am calling this. I am hitting on the same memory address. So suppose द रोल नंबर 101 इज रुद्र प्रताप वर्मा ओके एंड द निकनेम इज आरपीबी सो आई एम इफ आई एम कॉलिंग आरपीबी आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट 101 रोल नंबर इवन आई एम कॉलिंग रुद्र प्रताप वर्मा आई एम कॉलिंग 101 ओके आई एम कॉलिंग 101 सो इट डजंट मैटर बट हाउ दिस कंसेप्ट इज इंप्लीमेंटेड दिस कंसेप्ट इज कॉल्ड अलियासिंग okay this concept is called aliasing so question is how this would be implemented so very simple this concept is even you can say this concept is also called referencing okay referencing so now what is the syntax for same I am not sure about it will work on the turbo c++ or not but yes in c++ 11 it's working you can check this point whether it's working on turbo or not okay so int x is equal to 5 okay so this one is the normal variable so let's suppose I am taking the same okay to make the concept very clear so for example the variable name is Rudra Pratap Verma okay this one is the variable name and it contains the value that is the 1000 okay it contains the value that is the 1000 so now when Let's suppose I want to use this 1000 value. What I am supposed to use? I have to write this complete name again and again and again and again and again. So I don't want to write this huge name again and again and again. Then what I can do? I can make the concept of the. I can take the help of the concept of the aliasing. So how it is possible? So understand this point. For example, int of ampersand of x. Okay, ampersand or you can say. Rather than to take this x, you can say RPV. Okay, RPV is equal to Rudra underscore Pratap underscore Verma. So this concept is called aliasing or referencing. So even I print C out of RPV, if I print C out of RPV, if I print C out of Rudra Pratap Verma. Okay. So in the both of the cases, I will get the output 1000. In the both of the cases, I will get the output 1000. Okay. In the both of the cases that I will get the value that is the 1000. So what exactly meaning of this? This mean the Rudra Pratap Verma, let's suppose this one is the memory, Rudra Pratap Verma on 202. Here the value is 1000. So what I did? I just reference over here. I just make a reference over here. So whatever changes I made over here, let's suppose I am changing here the 10,000. Okay, I am changing over here the 10,000. Automatically now when I print this RPV, the 10,000 will be implemented. I print this Rudra Pratap Verma, again the 10,000 will be implemented. So what exactly difference between this X is equal to Y? This is called the assignment operator. This concept is called cloning basically. This concept is called cloning. The cloning mean x is different and y is different. So x value won't be reflect on the y value and the y value won't reflect on the x value. So in this concept is called aliasing. That's mean I'm talking about the same object. Okay. Sometime, yes, you have to do such kind of activity into your code because rather than to write again huge name, I now into throughout my code, I will use the RPV. Or even I am making the changes into the RPV automatically that reflect to the this Rudra Pratap Verma. Okay, so this is very small concept and I am not sure about it. And this one is your assignment that you are supposed to do. You are supposed to implement this concept into the turbo and you are supposed to tell me, sir, it's work or not work. But into C++ 11, yes, it will work. So I am writing very small again one more time. Int x is equal to 5. Okay, so you can note it out. Ampersand y is equal to x. This is called aliasing. So here, what I am doing here, what I am doing, okay, C out of x, C out of y, okay, C out of x, C out of y. So here, you will get the output 5, 5 in the both of the cases. Okay. So you are supposed to implement this concept, and you are telling me your assignment is that you will confirm it. It works on the turbo or not. Okay. So here. So now you will ask us what is the difference between this? If I do simply like this, x is equal to 5, int y is equal to 5. Okay. So these both are the different. X is equal to 5, int y is equal to x. So these both are different. So here, the x is another object, the y is another object. But y contain the value of x. Understand it. If I do it, c out of x, c out of y. Here the value in the both of the cases that you will get 5. But what if I change the value y is equal to 10? So again, I c out of x, again I c out of y. Now in the case of the y, you will get 10. In the case of the x, you will get 5. Okay? So here this concept is called cloning, that I am making a clone. That means this object is different object, this object is different. This is stored on the different memory and this is stored onto the different memory. But here, this concept is called aliasing. Here, if I make a changes over here, let's suppose x is equal to 15. I see out of x again, see out of y again, in the both of the cases that you will get the 15, 15. Because whatever changes you made over here automatically reflected over here. Because something like this, let's suppose the 15 is storing on this address and x and y, both are pointing over here. But in the case of this, x is different on memory location, y is on different memory location, and these contain the different values. Okay, whatever the changes that you made over here, that won't be reflected over here. So this is the very small concept, and the concept is called aliasing. Okay, and you can say the referencing as well. So this is a very small concept. Okay, so anyone having any doubt before proceed further, please let me know. Very small concept, and your assignment is that, please note it out. Your assignment is that you are supposed to tell me tomorrow whether this work on the turbo or not. Okay, I think the concept is clear to everyone, and very small concept, very easy concept. Haji, please.
Sir, code blocks mein chalega ye?
Check kar lena, dost. Okay. I am not sure. एक बार चेक कर लेना, ठीक है? क्योंकि मेरे पास सिर्फ C++ 11 है, तो वहाँ पे ये वर्क परफेक्टली, वहाँ पे कोई दिक्कत नहीं थी। लेकिन मुझे अब श्योरिटी नहीं है कि ये 11 नॉर्मल में चलेगा कि नहीं चलेगा, आप एक बार चेक कर लेना और मुझे भी अपडेट कर देना, ठीक है? ओके। So the next concept is pointer to pointer. Very simple concept, nothing special. Okay, nothing special, very easy. The basic terminology is same. So let's suppose how, first of all, understand what is pointer to pointer. Prior to understand this concept, what is pointer to pointer, let me show the syntax for same. Now you guys must familiar with this syntax. Let's suppose asterisk of p, q, or p you can say. Okay, so two time asterisk sign. It means this concept is called pointer to pointer. Okay, this concept is called pointer to pointer. Very simple concept, very easy concept. The fundamentals are same. There's still four lines. The fundamentals are same. Are always same. Okay, and this concept is called pointer to pointer. Okay, just raise your hands. How many of you are aware about this pointer to pointer concept, and you listen this concept first time? Okay, just raise your hand who's listened this concept first time. Please just raise your hand, be honest, don't worry. Okay, the person, I don't know the name. Okay, Simran even listen first time. Okay, anyone of you? Okay. So you guys listen this concept first time. Don't worry. Now you will clear very easily. Very simple concept. Don't worry about it. What is the meaning? Okay, now I'm going to the concept. What is the pointer to pointer? So now understand this concept. What is the pointer to pointer? It's mean pointer to pointer. Now I want to reach over here. So this one is my destination. Okay. This one is my destination. This one is my destination that I want to reach over here. And before reaching over here, there are two further destinations. So now question is, sir, where this concept is used? This concept is used when you are designing a games, when you are designing a map kind of application. Okay, in C++. that time you can take the help of these pointers as well. Okay, pointer to pointer concepts as well. So let's suppose this one your destination. The destination is, for example, 225. Okay, so this one is the address of this destination. So to reach this destination, there is a queue and there is a P. There is a queue and there is a P. So now what the concept is there? So for example, this 225, okay, this 225 is the destination. This address is referring over here, 225. Okay, 225. And this obvious, it's a pointer. It's a pointer. Definitely, it must have an address. It must have an address. And let's suppose the address of this one is 215. Okay, this pointer address. Obvious, if it is a pointer variable, definitely it is stored somewhere into the memory. So here, this address is 215. And this address is stored into the queue. Stored into the queue. Okay. Stored into the queue. So this one is the funda. So if I want to reach from this queue to this, let's suppose this X variable. Okay. So queue contains the address of this P pointer. Okay. 215. And this pointer variable store the address of this X, that is the 225. So if you want to reach over here, you have to pass through from this Q to P, okay, Q to P, and from P to X. That's it. This concept is called pointer to pointer. This concept is called pointer to pointer variable. So how it is possible? Very simple, nothing special. X is equal to 5. So here, int asterisk sign of P, okay, here P is equal to X. So P, what P stores? The address of X, okay? So for address of X, you have to implement this. Okay, P store the address of X. Now, what I am doing? Int of asterisk Q, okay? Asterisk Q. So what key Q? Q will store the address of P. That's it. Q store ampersand of P. That's it. So this one is the terminology. Now here, Q store the, understand this terminology, Q store the address of P, okay? And this is the pointer to pointer. That means it is pointing to another pointing variable. Okay? And Q is pointing to another pointing variable. Basically this one from left to right. P is pointing to another pointing variable. So Q store the address of P, okay, and P is again a pointing variable. And what P store? P stores the again the address of Q. So this one iterator. Same thing that you can implement over here, something like this. Asterisk of R. So yes, this is also possible. Pointer to pointer to pointer. Yes. One more time, yes, you can implement one more time. There is no limit, I suppose. But I am not sure. Okay. So this concept is called pointer to pointer variable. So how it is implemented, I understand it. Very small code that I am going to be show you. I think this concept is clear to everyone. If you have any doubt, please let me know before proceeding further. Now I am going to show you the implement of this concept. And I am listening second time. Okay, good. Haan ji, anyone having any doubt, please do before proceed further. Okay, good. So now I'm showing you how you can implement, how you can execute this concept. Very simple, very easy. Int main, you can note it out because I'm not going to show you the practical today. So you can do by your own self. Small things that you can do by your own. X is equal to 5 and int asterisk sign of P, which contain the ampersand of X. Okay. And let's suppose if you want to dereferencing, yes, you can do the reassignment over here rather than to do directly. ओके इंट एस्ट्रिक साइन ऑफ क्यू क्यू डेट स्टोर द एम परसेंट ऑफ पी ओके एंड इवन इवन यू कैन टेक लाइक दिस इंट एस्ट्रिक 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 आर विच कंटेन द address of q because q is also containing some address if it is available definitely it must have some address this is a pointer to pointer pointer to pointer to pointer pointer to pointer to pointer something like this okay okay so here what I am making more small twist p is equal to 6 observe this scenario very simple nothing else I just change the value of this x to 6 this x to 6 okay so this one is the concept that we already discussed in a number of time so now observe this scenario how you can print okay if I print asterisk sign of p so you can take c out as well print f as well percentage d I am making a short form to just understand this concept okay asterisk sign of p if I print q okay if I print let's suppose asterisk q okay if I print asterisk r okay asterisk r okay so if I print let's suppose asterisk r okay so now you guys will tell me what output I will get into the whole of the scenario so this one for example my memory location I am making a static memory location so here let's suppose this one is your r okay and the r address is 230 okay and here let's suppose this one is x okay and x address is 225 okay and this value is let's suppose 5 here the address is p and p contain 215 okay which take the address of 225 here the q okay and the address of the q is 202 and here it contain the address 215 that is the address of p and this r okay this one is a r and r contain the address let's suppose 202 okay so I am simplifying for making it more easy you can note it out because this one is the important one you can note it out okay r so this one to x okay this one to x and here this 230 okay so here you can over here okay so here the address is 230 so making over here 230 okay okay 230 no one second I made a mistake one second okay so q is containing 215 okay this p containing 225 okay again here the address is also there so here 225 and this r containing 202 and here this address is okay this one now this one okay I think everyone understand this thing because I am going to ask you the question what output you will get over here 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 haan ji please anyone clear about this picture this representation the memory representation haan ji please if you have any doubt please let me know before proceed further because I am going to ask you the question what output over here what output over here haan ji please haan ji please ask me any question I think this one is simple one pointer to pointer so don't get confused so pointer to pointer mean the variable which again contain the pointer variable address okay so let's suppose I am containing a address that address is again the pointer variable address okay हाँ जी शालू, डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन? प्लीज म्यूट योरसेल्फ इफ यू डोंट हैव एनी क्वेश्चन, प्लीज म्यूट. ओके सो नाउ यू गाइस विल टेल मी. सो एनीवन हु इज इंटरेस्टेड, आई एम नॉट पिक आउट द रैंडम, प्लीज टेल मी व्हाट आउटपुट आई विल गेट ओवर हियर. एनीवन प्लीज, एनीवन, इफ आई प्रिंट एस्टिक साइन ऑफ पी व्हाट आउटपुट आई विल गेट? The value I assign, the initial, the value of x is equal to 5. So it was 5. Then what I did, I assigned the address of x. So p contained the address of x. After that, I changed the value on this address. Whatever the p address is containing, that I am dereferencing and changing the content of that data. Let's suppose here, the earlier it was 5. Now I am assigning it was 6. Okay, so this line changed this value to 6. Okay, so perfectly fine, absolutely right that you give the perfect answer. After that, I took one variable that is again pointer to pointer variable which contains the address of those variable which is again a pointer variable. So repeating once again, this concept is called pointer to pointer. The queue is pointer to pointer, mean it's containing an address of that variable which is again a pointer variable. Okay, so here I assign address, I refer address of p. So my p is a pointer variable, so this one that I refer. And after that, there again the pointer to pointer to pointer, that is r. And again, this is containing a q, and q is again containing a address of the p, and p is again containing the address of a. So that means if you want to reach over r, okay, so reaching to the destination from r, or you can say to reach the actual value, to reach the end address, so you have to pass through to the three pointers. Okay, so again I initialize one pointer to pointer, again I initialize pointer to pointer to pointer, and I exactly don't know how you can pronounce it. I don't think so there is some special name for this particular thing, but here yes, the special name is pointer to pointer, but here I am not clear about what exactly this the special name. So I am, for my referencing, I am just taking the help of pointer to pointer to pointer. Okay, so now perfectly fine, you will get the output over here, that is the 6. Okay, what output you will get into this context when it will executed astic sign of you, what you will get? Please tell me what you will get.
Sir, 215.
It will get 215. Perfect. 215. Yes, it will get 215. No, it will not get 215. It will get 225. It will get 225.
Sir, six नहीं आएगी?
हाँ जी.
Sir, six नहीं आ सकती इसकी value, क्योंकि पहले
नहीं, 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 six नहीं आएगी, क्योंकि मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ क्यू के अंदर जो एड्रेस है उस एड्रेस पे क्या पड़ा है, तो जो एड्रेस है, द एड्रेस इज 215, और 215 एड्रेस कंटेन 225, सो दैट्स मीन यू विल गेट आउटपुट 225. अगेन दिस कांसेप्ट इज कॉल्ड डीरेफरेंसिंग. द डीरेफरेंसिंग मीन व्हाट नेक्स्ट पॉइंटर व्हिच आई हैव, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली दैट वैल्यू इज देयर. सो इन क्यू द एड्रेस इज 215, द एड्रेस इज 215, and on this address 215, what value that I have? I have 225. Okay, I have 225. So here only one star mean, that's mean I am dereferencing it onto my one step value. So my one step value is 215. Okay, I have this address. On this address that I am containing 225, that's mean the address of another variable. So now you guys will definitely, I'm sure you will get answer over this. हाँ जी, what output I will get over here?
Sir, इसमें 6 आएगा.
Yeah, perfect. इसमें आएगा 6. Why so? Because I am saying go to first pointer, dereffer it. Go to another pointer, dereffer it. So here it reach over here, again it reach over here, and after that it is giving me okay, the output is 6. The output is 6. Perfect. Now in this next output.
215.
star 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 three times star and r.
215.
Uh-huh. That's mean three times star. That's mean to this funda.
Six sir.
Yes, perfectly six. Perfectly six. Perfectly six. Okay. And here, what output I will get? Okay. Now you guys will tell me. Astic of r.
Ab aayegi 225.
Anji.
Ab aayegi 225.
Yeah. Ab aayegi. Now you will get 225. यहां पे गया, यहां पे वैल्यू कितनी थी? 202 पे गया तो वहां रेफरेंसिंग कर दी और वहां पे कितनी वैल्यू थी? 215. ठीक है, सॉरी 2 टाइम स्टार है तो 215 पे गया, 225 पे उसने मिला 225. तो मतलब अगर मैं इस कंसेप्ट को सीधे फंडे में समझूं तो ये राम है, ठीक है जी, ये राम है, ये श्याम है, ये मोहन है, ये सोहन है. ठीक है ना, मुझे सोहन तक जाना है तो मुझे इनसे निकल करके जाना पड़ेगा, बिकॉज सोहन मुझे नहीं जानता. ट्रांजिटिव रिलेशन, ए नोज टू बी, बी नोज टू सी, इट मींस ए नोज टू सी, दैट्स इट. सो दिस वन कंसेप्ट इज कॉल्ड पॉइंटर टू पॉइंटर, एंड योर असाइनमेंट इज यू आर सपोज टू इंप्लीमेंट इट. अंटिल अनलेस यू वॉन्ट इंप्लीमेंट इट, यू विल नॉट गेट द क्लैरिटी अबाउट दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. And sometime, yes, in the tough interview, the person can ask this concept, what is the pointer to pointer. In basic interview, I don't think so this question would be asked. But yes, in tough interviews, if someone is very much interested about pointers, then he or she can ask this type of question, what exactly the concept of the pointers to pointers. So I hope you guys are clear about this concept. So almost we cover pointer in great detail, but yes, still there are so many things still left, but yes, the fundamentals are now clear about pointers. Okay, so fundamentals are clear. Now I am moving ahead to the complicated part of the pointers. So you guys are always afraid of these terminologies now, which I am going to be discussing, because these are the fundamentals. Till now, whatever we describe in great detail, they are the fundamentals about the pointers. Now I am moving one step ahead. Again, the very important concept, that is the dynamic memory allocation. Very important concept. I will discuss the dynamic memory allocation into the context of the C. Then we will move to the C++. Because I already told you, whenever the concept of the pointer is there, definitely the questioning would be offered into the C language, maximum time. Haan ji. Anyone having any doubt for this terminology, because this is the very basic fundamentals of the pointers. So if you have clear cut idea about these things, now you can move ahead, you can proceed ahead, because there are any terminologies in the context of the functions as well. In the functions, the pointer are again highly used. Hanji, please tell me and explain this concept. Anyone having any question before proceed further, please let me know. Hanji, please. Haan ji, please. Okay, good. There is no question, mean you don't have any doubt. Okay, I'm going to describe the next concept. Again, the similar to the basic one as well, but the things are little changed over here. Okay, things are little changed over here. So now, the concept is pointers and dynamic memory allocation. Okay, dynamic memory. Dynamic memory mean the runtime memory. Okay, so what exactly meaning of this one, the dynamic memory allocation? So understand this concept first. If I categorized my memory, okay, if I categorized my memory, let's suppose this one is my memory. So whenever I executed the program, the memory is divided into these blocks. Here your code, whatever the code that you write, that is the code text. Okay, here the memory is reserved for the static and the global variables. Whatever you define the static variables or global variables, in our upcoming section, we will describe into the great detail about the global and the static variables. Then again, the stack. Okay, then again the stack, then again the heap. So this is the memory, you know, the representation. Whenever you implement the, you run your code, you execute your code, your memory is basically divided into the four blocks. The one is the code text where your code is placed, and another memory is reserved for the static and the global variables. The another memory is reserved for the stack. Another memory is reserved for the heap. And here the heap doesn't mean that your data structure heap. Keep this point into the mind. Okay. So heap mean, first we understand the concept heap. So let's suppose your memory is 4 GB, or you can say the 8 GB. Okay. So until this process, your 2 GB memory is reserved. Okay. For example, just take a simple example. Your 2 GB memory is reserved because this memory is dependent upon the size of your code and what exactly the requirement of your code. So let's suppose how many memory that I have left. The total I have left. One second. I think. This heap is basically your entire memory. This heap is basically your entire memory. Entire memory mean your hard disk as well. Let me check. Just give me a second. Because I am little confused over here. This point. Okay, just wait for a second. I come back. Heap in C memory. Heap in C language. In computer science, heap is a specialized tree-based data structure which is actually almost max. Store data in some variable amount processed and not be executed. For example, a program. Okay, so your heap is basically free floating memory. Okay, the free memory mean where your entire RAM is there. For example, 2 GB and the 6 GB. Okay, let's suppose this 6 GB memory. This is the free memory which is available for processing. Okay, but not used by your entire code. But not used by this code, because whenever I execute code, I compile the code. Let's suppose the 2 GB memory is reserved for these kind of things, and rest remaining 8 GB is free. Okay, so this concept is called dynamic memory. So it means that I am going to use this stack, I am implementing my things into the heap. Okay, I am implementing my things into the heap, and this memory is not automatically managed. This is the important one. This memory is not automatically managed. It means that if you have allocated some object into heap, very much important to deallocate them. Otherwise, your memory will be stored. It will not gonna to release automatically. But in the context of the stack, whatever that you define initialized into the stack automatically deallocated or deinitialized. Okay, deallocated and deinitialized. So this is a very important concept to move ahead in the context of the dynamic memory allocation. I am repeating once again, whenever you are implementing the stack kind of things, automatically the memory is implemented and memory is automatically deleted. But in the case of heap, whatever object that you define, for example, you define an object over here, this one is your free memory, and this object is defining over here, and you are hitting on this memory, okay? And after completion of entire execution, it is important one that you must have to deallocate, you must have to deinitialize. You must have to delete it, okay? As you now you much familiar with the terminology new and delete, malloc, realloc, calloc, and free, okay? So these four terminologies in the context of the C, in the context of the C++, only two terminology, new and delete. So it means that you have to decide your object into the heap, and heap is a free floating memory. Here you are implementing it, but make sure that after using it, you have to free this much amount of memory. Otherwise, this memory will still remain into the code. And if you want to release this memory, if you want to release this memory, then what will happen? The memory leak kind of things will be happen. Okay, I will show you this concept practically, what exactly that memory leak, how exactly the memory leaks, how you can implement the concept of the memory leak. Okay, so it is mandatory whenever you are playing with the dynamic memory, and you must have to release that memory. If you want to release that memory, then what will happen? That memory will be reserved throughout the entire process. So this condition, critically, this condition is called memory leak condition. So now I think you must about the get the basic terminology, basic familiarities with the concept of the dynamic memory allocation. And very useful, the dynamic memory allocation concept is very useful in the context when you define, you produce the drivers. Okay, for example, printer drivers. Okay, if you want to design a printer drivers, at that time, this kind of terminologies are highly used. That is the dynamic memory allocation. Okay, so now understand how you can implement the dynamic memory allocation. So you can even Google for these kind of things. Okay, you will get the more clarity if you have any doubt for these kind of things, because this one is again very big topic, that the architecture of the C, how exactly the C store the object and how C implement the object. But I explain you into the nutshell, into the very small, into the brief introduction, that what exactly the things are happen on the backend. So for more information, you can do the Google, you can do the YouTube, you will get the much more clarity, but you must have, you must spend some time over there, okay, to understand this concept. So this is very basic familiarity, basic definition about how exactly the dynamic memory kind of things are implemented. So heap, stack, okay, the static variable and the global variable and the code text. Here your code text is there, the static memory and the global variable are stored into this portion, and the stack implementation done, and the free floating memory, that is called the heap. Okay, so now, so these things are technically called the dynamic memory allocation. Okay, technically we will say this concept to the dynamic memory allocation. So now the question is how we can implement this kind of things into the C and C++. So majorly I will focus on the C, because whenever you sit into the interview room, the concept for the dynamic memory allocation, the people are going to be asked into the question for the C, because the C is first choice for the context of the pointers. Okay, when you are going to implement these things into the C, so we have four terminologies: malloc, okay, calloc, okay, malloc, calloc, and realloc. Okay, so these are the three terminology to assign the data, and this terminology is used to free, to release the memory. So these three terminology will assign the memory, and these the last terminology, that is the free, automatically name specify itself, which will free the resource or free the memory. Okay, and after that, if I compare the same thing into the C++, then we have a two terminology. The one is called new and delete. Okay, so this is the one of the major difference between the C, C++ in the context of the dynamic memory allocation. So here only two terminology, here the terminology, the four basic terminologies. So now the question is how you can perform such kind of things, how you can implement practically. So I'm going to be first disclose these things into the C. Okay, so if my first choice is C, then I will move to the C++. Okay, observe this scenario. So very simple concept, int, main, as we know, so no need to explain this point. So here int A, okay, here I am initializing a static pointer, okay, that is the P. So observe this scenario. The P will store the address of the memory. Okay, the P will store the address of the memory. So this memory, now earlier the P is storing the memory which is available into the stack, whatever we seen into the last examples. But now for this point of time, this one is my, let's suppose, the entire memory. Okay, this one is my entire memory. Here, this one is the portion, let's suppose that four blocks, three blocks. Okay, the code text, and then your global variable, static variable, and your stack. So this one is the one memory, and this one is the free floating memory. Okay, this one is the free floating memory. Now my concern is that I want to store the object which is on the free floating memory. That means on this heap. Okay, so let's suppose I want to store this memory over here. So for ultimately, what is memory? Ultimately, what is memory? Memory is the storage location. Okay, for example, this one is the storage location. So I am saying that please give me this block. Please give me this piece. Okay, please give me this piece. I needed this piece, and this piece is available into the heap. Again, this one is the memory address. Let's suppose this memory is starting from 202. Okay, or you can say 802. Okay, just imagine the scenario. 802. This memory is 802 to 806, 4 bytes. Okay, I need this memory. I need this memory, and this memory is stored into the heap. So this starting position is 802 and the end position is 806, and this is the total, the 4 bytes, and I want to take this memory. But this memory is stored into the heap. How you can allocate it? Understand this point. So this one is a pointer variable which will store this address, that is the 802, which will store this address, that is the 802. So now the question is how we can initialize the dynamic memory. So as I discuss, three terminologies are there for assignment, that is the malloc, calloc, and realloc. So these terminology that you must have to be used, okay, to get understanding the concept inside the compiler. So whenever you use the concept of the malloc, compiler will automatically understand, okay, now it's an instruction for me that now I will hit into the heap and I will get out the piece from that particular heap. Okay, so now see the syntax, how you can define. Don't worry, very easy. Don't get confused. Int, asterisk sign, okay, and malloc. Okay, this one is the instruction. Malloc is a function, okay, which is available for C only to allocate the memory. Okay, and the size of is a operator. If you don't have any knowledge, I will explain this point as well, the size of int. Okay, observe this scenario very carefully. So when I give the instruction, this one is the instruction given to the compiler. I am going to use malloc. Compiler will get intimated that now whatever the memory that is assigned to this p variable, that is the pointer variable, obvious, if it is a pointer variable, it will take some memory address. So whenever I use this malloc, immediately compiler gets the instructions, okay, now I have to hit into the heap. Now when I have to hit into the heap, what type of data, what memory that I have to assign? Malloc give the instruction to the compiler, hit into the heap. And this parameter specify what size of memory that I have to pick. So size of is a operator or a function, you can say the function, which is available into the C++, which give you what is the size of your machine, your architecture to store this integer. Let's suppose my machine take 4 byte. Okay, my machine take 4 byte. So here automatically the parameter that is converted to the 4 byte. Okay, if your architecture takes 8 byte, so automatically the parameter is converted 8 byte. Here, if your architecture takes 16 byte, automatically this parameter converted to the 16 bytes. So I am assuming that my operating system take the 4 byte. Okay, so here this parameter is converted automatically for the 4 byte. So what it means that malloc will hit on the heap and it will reserve 4 bytes. So automatically it pick out the 4 bytes. Okay, it pick out the 4 bytes. And now this, okay, so this concept. So this concept means you hit into the heap and pick up the 4 bytes which reserved, okay, which reserved and which is stored into the heap. Now the question is, you are using this 4 byte, you must have tell to the compiler these 4 bytes are specifically used for integer only, okay, for integer only. So it's mean that you have to do the type casting, okay. So you have to tell the compiler, compiler, give me 4 bytes, okay, and convert that 4 byte into the integers. So this concept is called type casting, you can say, okay. So you can say, okay, so you can say, so this one is the way, this one is the way. So now I am repeating one last time. So malloc is a function which give the instruction to the compiler, hit into the heap and reserve 4 bytes for me, because my architecture take the 4 byte, that is the size of operator which will tell you what exactly the size of the integer inside your architecture, and reserve it or typecast it for integer only. That's mean I'm going to store over here the integer values. That's it. That's it. This concept is called dynamic memory allocation. Okay. So what I am doing now, asterisk sine of p is equal to 20. So here I allocated the value that is the 20. Okay. Here I allocated the value that is the 20. So 20 value I assigned over here. So if I close this here, okay. So this memory will never be released. This memory will never be released, as we discuss into the dangling pointer case. This memory will never be released. So this memory will still consumed. So, but I want to free it. Okay, I want to free it. So here, very simple, free of p. That's it. So that's mean you have to free it after using, after processing. It is mandatory that you have to free it. If you won't free it, then it will keep inside the memory and it will store the data. Okay, it will store the data. So this one is the very basic terminology, very easy terminology. Okay. So I think now the picture is clear. So let's suppose you want to dynamic array allocation. Dynamic array allocation, very simple, very easy, nothing to do special. So even you can do something like this. P is equal to int of asterisk sine of this one. Okay, then malloc, you can say 3 into size of int. Yes, you can take like this. So here it's mean 3 into 4, 12 bytes. 12 bytes mean the number of item like this, 3. Okay, 3 into 4. That's it. That's mean I am reserving a location for consecutive 3 bytes. Consecutive 12 bytes basically. So this one is the way dynamic memory allocation. Again, I am repeating. Okay, again, I am repeating. For example, int of asterisk of p is equal to int of star. Okay, typecasting malloc. Okay, the malloc is the function. 3 into size of. Okay, size of int. That's it. So it's mean 3 into size of 4, 12. It's mean 12 bytes consecutively will be stored into the memory. Yani ki, agar main isko dekhun, to A of 3. That's it. Like this. Okay, so this one is the dynamic memory, dynamic array allocation. This one is the dynamic array allocation. Okay, so this one is the way. I think now the picture is clear. Now the picture is clear. So this one is the malloc, okay, malloc. Another one is a calloc. Another one is a calloc, okay. Calloc mean exactly same. Calloc is exactly same, okay. What is the difference between malloc and calloc? Very simple. There is no difference. Int, asterisk sign. Okay, let me write the in gray detail. There is no much difference between malloc and calloc. Okay, so simply you can say int asterisk sine of p is equal to int star, okay, int star calloc. Rather than to use malloc, you are supposed to use calloc. Here what I did, 3 multiply by size of int. Here what I am doing, 3 comma size of int. It's mean I need a array of size 3. That's it. You don't need to perform the calculation. Put out the size. Here the 4. Okay, the 4 mean A of 4. Here the 5 mean the 5. And you have to pass another parameter with the help of this comma. So this first parameter refer to the size. Okay, what size array that you are looking for. And this one is the type. How much memory that is actually required to store this much amount of data. Okay. So this one is this difference. So there is one more difference is there. There's a technical difference. When you allocate with the help of malloc, okay, this one, let's suppose with the help of malloc, this one is with the help of calloc. There is only one technical difference between these two. Whenever you store the array with the help of malloc, it automatically store the garbage value. Okay, it automatically store the garbage value. It automatically store the garbage value over here. But whenever you define an array with the help of the calloc, what it do? It fill the array automatically with the zeros. This is the only technical difference between these two. One is the syntactical difference. The syntax is here it will take only one parameter. Okay, one parameter mean that you want to store 3 into 4. That's mean the 12 byte consecutively. But here the number of size that you have to pass with the comma separated. The first parameter will be defined as a you can say the size, and another parameter what type of size, integer, float, double, or what type. And another difference, when you define with this, it automatically store the garbage value, but you don't want to store garbage value. You want to store zeros automatically. When you store zeros automatically, then you are supposed to use this calloc. The one is the syntactical difference, and the second one is technical difference between these two, malloc and calloc. Okay. So the third one is, reallocate. Okay. Reallocate, name specify itself, reallocate. Reallocate mean, what is the meaning of the reallocate? Reallocate mean, earlier I have 20 students into the class. Okay, I have 20 students in the class. Now my class extended to the 40 students. So same room, the same classroom that I want to extend. Earlier here only 20 chairs because the memory was only for the 20. But now my student strength is increased to the 40. So I want to change this room to the size of 40. So same thing, whenever you define an array with the 3 elements, now your requirement get increased. Now your requirement become to 30. So what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to reallocate. Okay, you are supposed to reallocate. So how you can do it? Very simple. I'm writing a small code for the same. Let's suppose this one is an array. Okay, this one is an array. The character of asterisk of p, I'm taking one array, and here p is equal to malloc. Okay, malloc 20 into you can say size of char. Okay, 20 into size of char. So it's mean that 20 into the size of char. If I define it a of 20, very simple way. Okay, so here very small function, str copy. So I don't know you know about this function or not. This one is a function we will describe the later on when we will understand the concept of the string. So string copy. Okay, string copy. So I am copying what I am going to be copy. Let's suppose US data. Okay, I am going to copy this US data into this. Okay, into this. So this with the help of this string copy. Okay, now PTR is equal to, again I am reallocating it. Okay, so again I am reallocating it. Earlier the size was 20, now I am reallocating it. I am increasing the size of this existing memory. Okay, existing memory. So here P is equal to realloc. Okay, realloc. So here PTR, or not PTR, you can say the P because our pointer name is P. P is equal to 100 into size of char. Size of char. So what I did? So earlier my size was 20. Okay. Now my size increased to 100. The same room size I increased to the 100. Earlier I have only 20 bytes. Now the 20 bytes, ठीक है, now 100 bytes. So with the help of realloc, you can reallocate, you can increase the size. Okay, reallocate. Again, I am making one more copy, str copy, ptr, US data technologies. Now, earlier, let's suppose the size was very small. Okay, the size were, let's suppose it's a 4. It's a 4 size. So I am not able to copy this one. I am not supposed to adjust this one to the P. But my requirement is this one. Let's suppose I want to copy this US data technologies. Okay. So to store this US data technology, I need a large size. I need a large size into the same room. So what I did, I increased the size of this. Okay, with the help of reallocate. Earlier the size was, let's suppose, the 4. Now the size become the 100. And now I am able to copy it. The same concept. Your class size is 20, but you have 40 students. Now how you will manage it? Definitely you have to increase the size of room. The same thing over here, that you are increasing the size of memory. How I can increase? How my compiler will get intimated? My compiler will get intimated with the help of this realloc. So these three terminologies are there. And the last terminology, that is the free, important one, free of P. That's it. Until unless you want free, it will keep on resuming the memory. So to releasing the memory, you must have used the terminology that is the free, because this memory is not stored into the stack. And whenever the values are not stored into the stack, that's mean the values are storing into the heap. When the values are stored into the heap, it means that you must have to take care about the memory management concept, because they are not automatically manipulated. Okay, so I think more than sufficient for this today. I explained into the great detail the pointers and the concept behind the pointers, the pointer to pointer, one of the most important concept into the tough interviews. And yes, 90% chances are there you will get the difference between the malloc, calloc and the realloc in the context of the pointers. So I show you what exactly the technical difference and the statically difference between these three terminologies. And the free is a common one. That's mean that you have to free the memory as well. Okay, so any question before closing this session, you can ask me. Anyone having any doubt, any question before close this session, you can ask me. Haji, please. Haji, kisi ka koi question ho, to aap mujhse ek bar pooch lijiye before close this session. Haji, no question? I'm assuming that this concept is clear. So I think tomorrow is Saturday. So you will get notified by your college authorities whether the test is there or not. Okay, if the test is there, you will get the link. If no test, that means you won't get any kind of link. I will confirm by evening or maybe in the morning. Okay. So tomorrow morning might be the test is there. If the tomorrow morning the test is there, that's mean you have a time. The test definitely will be happen into the evening. If you get the link for the same at night, so you have a test in the morning. Okay, so the test is based on your previous questions, previous topics, and as well as for these topics as well, the pointers and the 2D array and so on. I'll cover all these things into the great detail into that text. And probably the test would be the technical test. The technical test mean that you have to be attempt practically inside your mind, not into the compiler. Okay, so you are not supposed to take the help of the compiler. Choice over there, because this is the test for the preparation for your interview. And you are not supposed to take the help of the C++ compiler. You have to implement, you have to execute all these things into your mind. Okay, and then you are supposed to give the answer for the same. Please don't take the help of the compiler. Okay, So this point of time, I'm reducing the time as well. The time would be for say for the same, the 15 minute, and you have only 15 question, and you are supposed to solve all those question into the one question, 1 minute. Okay. And the topics for the same is your previous topic as well as whatever we learned into this week, that would be the part of this test. So before closing this session, anyone having any doubt, any question, please let me know before proceed or before closing it, basically. Haji, anyone having any doubt, any question regarding this topic that what we discussed today? Okay, so it's mean there is no question. So everything is clear to you. So thank you. Thank you for listening me patiently. Thank you very much.